Hello, algebra students. Let's take a look at this tricky example. It says a student solved three equations as shown. First, check if each solution is correct. If not, find the error. Now, you're not going to see an example just like this on the GED test. I kind of put two concepts together on this little review to help you practice two things. All right, but they do have problems of this style on the GED, the second part where it just says find the error. You will sometimes see these tricky solving equations examples where you see the student's step-by-step work and you need to find the error in their work. But this first part, this is just a skill I want you to have. The test doesn't require it, but I want you to be able to check your work. Okay, guys, you should know how, if you solve an equation, to check if your answer is correct or not, okay? And it's all about understanding what this means here. If I say t equals 9.4, what am I saying? I'm saying that if you take this number and put it up here where t was, you plug it in for t, it's going to give me a true equation, meaning the left-hand side will equal the right-hand side of the equation, okay? And so you can literally just plug in 9.4 into that left-hand side of the equation. You can do 36 minus 5, and instead of writing t, write 9.4. And you can also just put that entire thing into your calculator. Okay, you will have your calculator when we do examples like this, so you don't have to know how to do it by hand. But I forgot to project up my calculator, so that means I have to do the decimal by hand. Lame. So order of operations says multiply before I subtract, so I will do that. 5 times 4 is 20. 5 times 9 is 45. 46, 47. One decimal place in the problem, one in the answer. That is about 47. And I still have the 36, I still have the minus, and once again, you don't have to know how to do this by hand. You can do it in your calculator, but 36 minus 47, I'm taking away more than I have, so I'm going to end up negative, and negative what? Negative 11. All right, so when I simplified the left-hand side, did it give me 11? No, it did not. It gave me negative 11, which means, is this guy a solution? It sure is not. So is the solution correct? No, it's incorrect. Now we have to figure out where they went wrong, which, like I said, is the style of question you might see on the GED test. And I can see it right from the very start. Can you see it in the first line? Take a look here. And if you struggle to see it, by the way, guys, just imagine what you would do. Look at this equation. I have 36 minus 5t equals 11. And I like the number that the student started with. They took a look at the side that the letter was on. T is over there on the left. They saw there were two numbers to get rid of, 36 and 5. And they decided to get rid of the right one first, right? That 36 is separated from t with a plus or minus sign, which means it's a term, which means we should take it away first. Okay, anything adding or subtracting goes first. The problem is how they decided to take it away. This student looked at this minus sign and they said, I'll do the opposite, I'll plus. But that minus sign, that tells you what the 5t is doing. The 5t is subtracting. Remember, your goal is to zero out terms. Things that are adding, subtracting, they're not gonna go away. They're not gonna cancel unless they become zero, okay? And 36 plus 36, sorry, you guys. That's not zero. That's 72. If you do that first, you're just making this problem messier instead of neater. So what should that student have done? That student should have subtracted 36 from both sides. Now, you say, but then what about that minus sign? You're right, it's still there, but it's on the 5t. If I take 5t away from nothing, I'm just in debt 5t. I'm at negative 5t. And then your calculator would give you some negative numbers here, and there would be some negatives to solve, which again, your calculator could handle. But that first part. That was the problem, okay? Where they added 36 when they should have subtracted that 36 away. Ooh, tricky, tricky. Okay, let's look at that next example now. So again, let's test our solution. Would 16 make this original equation true? Well, if I put 16 in for h on the left-hand side, would it then equal the right-hand side? Let's take a look. Well, if I have that 3 plus 4h and I replace the h with 16, let's see what happens. Oh, this one's easier, no decimals. 16 times 4, again, you guys can do this in your calculator. So I get 24, carry the 2, 64. And to that, I need to add 3, and I would get 67. Did it give me 23? It did not. So this solution is also incorrect. Now, where did this student go wrong? Let's just get rid of this. Let's take a look at that first step. Again, if you really, you're going to struggle to see it, it's really hard to see other people's errors unless you try to do the work yourself. But this student is the one who said, oh, I need to get rid of whatever's adding or subtracting first. And they chose to subtract 4. And once again, this didn't work because they're not using opposites the way they think they are. They're autopiloting. Look at what that 4 is doing with h. That 4 and that h are shoved together. So even though there's a plus sign in front of it, that 4 is multiplying with h. That is not going to cancel. Subtracting 4 from that is not going to make that 4 go away. You're just kind of doing nonsense. First step that this student should have done is to take 3 away from both sides. And then it would have been easy to see that 4 is a multiplier and would eventually get divided away, and I would get h is equal to 5. All right, so what was the error here? They thought that they tried to cancel multiplication with subtraction. That didn't work. Whew, my goodness. All right, last example here. And again, can you guys go get your calculator? I'm sorry, I forgot mine. But plugging in negative numbers is not something I want you to worry about doing by hand, okay? But I have to because I forgot my calculator. So let me bust out the original equation. 5 plus j over 3 equals negative 4. If I put in negative 17 for j, will I get negative 4 out of the left-hand side? Let's see. 5 plus negative 17 over 3. There's a grouping on the top of this fraction. I should do this first. If I only have $5 and then I add some debt to that, I go down by 17. I am going to end up in the hole. I took away more than I had by 12, and I still need to divide that by 3. And negative 12 divided by 3 gives me negative 4. So this one does check. This sucker is correct. All right, you guys. Woo, tricky. You got this. Especially if you had a calculator, you'd really get this. All right.